So I've got a Pigma Micron 03 pen and we're just starting to ink now. I'm not worried about smudging or anything like that because I'm going to ink over everything anyway. I think the teeth are the best thing about this creature drawing, I think. I like drawing uneven teeth like that. So this fury creature. Is it like a creature that I know nothing about? Except from the screenshots that I've took off Google Images. The only thing I can slightly compare it to is maybe like a Doom creature. It looks like looks something like that. But as I haven't played the game, I don't properly know. Looks like a cool looking creature though. As you can see now in the inking stage, I can change things, I can shape things to how I want now. I can sort of keep lines, I can get rid of lines, change them. Only change them once though, because once I've drawn over them, that's it. It's quite permanent. I quite like this to ink. To ink a drawing, it's the best thing. Definitely when I come to colour this, I'm going to draw in the lasers coming off the claws or the arms at the end. So I'm going to add some more texture to the, you know, the arms as well as we go along. So we're not just going to leave it as that. So cross hatching. Draw the outline of the eye. This, maybe make them into little sort of curved lines just to change the texture of the mouth. Now if I was sure that these creatures breathe fire, then I would have drawn a bit of fire coming from the mouth, but I wasn't exactly sure if that was one of the other characters near it. I don't know, on a couple of the screenshots, so I just left it. But if I was to draw this creature again, I probably would draw just some added fire there. I should have done that to start with, but I did a bit more of a twist on it, but well, started now, so thank you. some shading under there. This is like he's on like a path of some sort. Fill that in black with probably a Sharpie marker pen. Zoom back and just take a look and start inking again. It's important to do that a few times just to make sure the drawing's going as you planned. And even if it doesn't, you can just start again. It's only a drawing. Drawing lots of excessive detail, which is actually supposed to be some of the form of the, like the skull. I know there's a section there on the skull that I can see, and a section underneath, but it's best to try and give it, you know, some suggestions of structure. Of excessive detail. Probably get the Sharpie marker pen out. Maybe go over the middle part there. So now the rest of the eye, when I come to colour it, will be like a dark brown. And there's certainly some areas here which I don't know, I'll leave for now because I need to start going back through this fine ink pen. Give this some texture, which you'll probably see once I erase most of the pencil lines. Give a good guideline for the colour anyway. So we can sort of finish a lot of the legs and make them look a little bit better, or keep them the same. It's entirely up to you. Actually, I like this texture. It'll look quite effective once I start to finish inking the legs anyway. Let's focus on drawing the rest of the legs first. Let's draw a lot of the outlines. The other side of the legs. So you can see it's coming together. Definitely the colour stage will help bring it more together, design wise. Not bad for a first attempt. Try and do a lot of this top texture now. So a lot of this area I'm going to Sharpie marker it. Let me scribble it just to speed things up. Pick my pen. Jesus Christ. Butterfingers. I'm sure I've done that before. Scribbly. You know, texture onto there. All sorts of shit. Jesus. And then maybe just it was the Sharpie marker pen that I dropped as well. And then we'll just I left the top off. Oh no, sorry. I've revived it. And then just still we can clear things up a bit later on the drawing. Just like to do a little bit more of a darker sort of design or shadow. Be really quick about it, really, and clean things up later. Or maybe off camera, that sort of thing. And then when I come to like erase the pencil lines anyway, that'll be our chance to maybe add extra linked details. And I think this Sharpie is running out as well. Good man. Fits. Sharpie. He's had a good life, that Sharpie marker, I think. But it's going straight in the bin. So yeah, that's like the little design for now. So I'll just show you what I've done so far. It's workable. It's not brilliant, but I have fun drawing it anyway. So in the next video, we'll try and do the colour work. So I'll see you in the next video. Cheers now.